Hi everyone, this is Nick, and I got a question over on one of our videos about how to make a countdown timer in your slides using the morph transition. And this question was from Lisa, who asked, can we do this in with longer time intervals? So she needed to create a timer in her slides, or a countdown timer, a break timer, or something like that, that was about 10 minutes long. So you can do that. I was kind of thinking through some ways to do it. Using the morph transition, you could definitely do the same exact sort of technique that we used in that video. I'll link to that above, but I think it would get pretty tedious to have all of those numbers if you wanted it to count down by sort of seconds. You could definitely do it by minutes, and then the slide wouldn't change very often, except for on every minute it might change. So I wanted to give you a couple different options. So the first one is just a really easy plugin. It's a PowerPoint add-in and it's free, and there are several of them. So all you need to do in order to download an add-in in PowerPoint is go up to the Insert tab on the ribbon, go under this add-in menu right here, click Get Add-ins. And what I did is I just searched for timer and then pushed enter, and then you'll get a whole bunch of them. I thought I liked this break time add-in, so I'm just gonna click on add, and it will then ask you to continue, and then it will add in this timer that you can then set to any time that you like. So right now it's defaulted to 10 minutes. The other thing that you can do from this menu right here is you can add an image. So it asks you what kind of break you want to insert, or what kind of timer you wanna insert. So this could be a coffee break, and then it gives you this nice coffee image. It could be a drinks, and then you have drink there. It could be a sandwich break, and then you have the sandwich. So it's not really that customizable when you put an add-in like this in. You can't customize the fonts, the colors, things like that, but you can customize the location of where you want it. And then all you have to do is just click on start, and it will go ahead and start for you. You can also pin the controls when they're stopped. So if this box is selected, when you stop it, these controls will stay at the bottom. If it's unselected, they'll go away. So you can kind of do that, and that could be a nice sort of like fix for your solution when you wanna add these really quick and easy timers if you don't care too much about the style and the branding. But I wanted to show you a way that I thought through doing a longer timer in a slide that's a little bit more custom. And we'll go over here to this next slide, and I just want to show you. So this top here, it's just a line and a text box. I said time remaining here, and then what I did is I insert 10 boxes, 10 rectangles of equal size, and put them together in the PowerPoint slide. So these are all just 10 individual rectangles that I got from that insert tab, the shapes, and then the rectangles. You go ahead and just put in a rectangle there. Now once you have this and you have the text formatted the way that you like it, I thought we're gonna do this 10-minute countdown timer here. I want to put a rectangle of the same size in the back. So I'm going to go ahead and size this exactly the same height as my others, and then I'm just going to stretch it all the way across the screen, and I'm going to actually put a white border around this one because I have a two-point white border around my other boxes. And now you're going to right-click and put this to the back so you don't see it. So I'm going to add that to the back. Now what we're going to do is we're going to add some animation to these boxes, and you can add animation to anything on your slides. You can add them as entrance animations, as effect animations within the slide, or as exit animations. So we're going to use the exit animation pane for this example here. So right here, I'm going to click on the 10-minute box. We're going to go up to the animation tab here, and then down here under the animation menu, click this drop down until you get to the red section. These are the exit animations. I'm going to use the wipe animation here. I'm going to click it. It's going to apply a wipe animation, so it's going to have that gray box exit out in a wiping fashion. And I don't want it to do this up and down motion. I want it to go left to right. So we're going to go ahead to the effect options right here, and I'm going to say from the left. And now you get a little preview of what that looks like. Now you can also set the timing of these animations. So what you can do, go over here with this animation selected right here. Under the animation timing tab, we're gonna say we want this to start on the mouse click. So you're gonna start this animation with your mouse click. And then for the duration here, you might wanna put 1 minute. So we're gonna say 1:00:00 and push enter. Now you see that it actually didn't give me what I wanted it to do. It actually defaults to 59 seconds. I think that's the maximum amount of time that you can add to a duration on an animated object in PowerPoint. So what we're gonna do to fix that is just add a little delay. So it's gonna be a 1 second delay right here. and that's gonna start on the click. Now, I want that to disappear over the span of 1 minute, and then I want the same thing to happen with this box, but I want it to start after the previous animation. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go with the 9 minute box selected. We're gonna go to the animation, the exit animation tab there. We're gonna click on wipe. And again, I'm going to apply the from the left option here. And instead of on click, we're going to say after previous. Now, when I click on after previous, if we open the animation pane, you can now see that this is my first rectangle that's going to disappear. My second rectangle is going to disappear, start disappearing after that first one. But I also want this to be that 59 seconds. So what we'll have to do here, up here in that duration tab, we'll add 59 seconds. And then again, I'm going to add this 1 second if we really want to be exact. It's going to start just a little bit. So I want to show you what this looks like now in preview mode. I'm going to go ahead and put it in slideshow mode, and then we're going to click. And now this is going to go really slowly because it's 10 minutes. But as I talk, you can start to see that the gray box is slowly wiping across the screen, and it's just revealing that blue box. Now the time remaining is in gray. We've kind of encoded that in our legend at the top. So as this goes, the 10 minute is going to be removed. The blue box is going to be revealed. And then at the end of this whole 10 minute string, we will have just a blue box with no time remaining. And if we wanted to add sort of a final text box at the end saying your time is up, you could do that exact same thing. I'm going to escape out of this and show you then how we can make this happen. So, and actually for this, Lisa, I'm going to reduce the delay. I'm always going to keep that 1 second, reduce the duration, but I'm going to keep the 1 second delay so that we can see everything happening at once. So let's go ahead to this 10 minute, and I'm just going to go ahead and update this to 4 seconds. And keep the 1 second delay. And then for the 9 minute box, I'm gonna say 4 seconds and keep the 1 second delay, and it's set to after period or after previous. Now, what we wanna do, we could do that exact same thing for each of the subsequent boxes, or we can use the animation painter, which is a quicker way to apply the exact same animation from the previous object to other objects. So let's go ahead and click on the 9 minute box because that's set to the after previous setting that we want. I'm gonna go up here to my animation painter and I'm gonna double click this. If I double click this, you can see now that little paintbrush icon pops up, and that means the animation painter is activated. Now, whatever I click on the screen, that same animation sequence will apply to that box. So let's go ahead and click the 8 minute box. And now you can see over here, it's kind of applying that for me. I'm gonna click the 7 minute box. I'm gonna click the 6 minute box, and it kind of gives you a preview, but if you just click it again, it'll force the animation there, so you don't have to wait for that whole preview to play every single time. And I'm just gonna do that all the way down to the 1 minute box, and then click the animation painter again to deactivate it. Now let's go ahead and put this in slideshow mode and see what it looks like. And remember, we have to click the first time to activate the animation sequence. So I'm clicking now. Perfect. The 10 minute goes, then the 9 minutes should go. Remember, there's that 1 minute, that 1 second delay, because for your purposes, you're gonna set that duration to 59 seconds plus the 1 second delay. But this is gonna be an exact timing if you wanted that. If you didn't quite care about that 10 second gap, you could probably just keep the animation without that extra 1 second delay. But it looks pretty cool. I think it's kind of a fun little engaging timer that you could kind of make in your slide to kind of count down from 10 minutes to 1 minute or whatever sort of time interval that you need to do. But remember, it's probably gonna have to be in 1 minute chunks because PowerPoint doesn't allow us to do animation, apply animation that's longer than that 59 seconds. So pretty cool. And then at the end, I could pop up a text box here saying your time is up. So Lisa, I hope that this video helped or at least gave you a little bit, some ideas for what you might be able to do in a timer. Anyone else who's watching, I hope you will like this video, subscribe to my channel, click the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. Remember, you don't need to be a professional designer to look like one using the software that you have and you use every day already. So I hope you all have a wonderful day. It was a great time making this video for you, and I'll see you all next time.